Lou! We're back! Yeah, so after about a dozen or two attempts, we finally, Quintania has finally dropped the Tinkle Bell. I did not steal the flame shield. I did not get a flame shield. However, doesn't matter because you can steal them from bombs. Over. Where are they? No, grenades. Yeah, you can steal unlimited flame shields from these dudes, so it doesn't matter if you didn't get one. Okay, so now that I... Yeah, so now that I've gotten the ultra-rare boss drop... Well, it's not that rare, it's like got a 4% chance of dropping, a 4 or 5. Yeah, I think a little over 4%. But it's annoyingly rare. It's annoyingly rare, not like infuriatingly rare. It's not like a... Okay, so now that the boss is been defeated, I will... I'll put Paris back to... their old job. What is it? Samurai. Okay. Yeah, so this, I'll be going to the... Oh yeah, it's just a delay. I was checking the stream and didn't appear to be doing anything, but it was just, it was just because I was on the menu screen like 10, 15 seconds ago, so it's, I believe you can fight one of the summon bosses from World 1 or 2 in this room, in this castle. I believe this is the encounter that replaces it, if you've already defeated that boss, obtained that summon, and crypt that flag, it will switch to this one, I believe. Has a volume? Ooh! Well, lucked out, got two procs in a row. I think it's got like a 25% chance of casting, so that's a 1 in 16 chance of getting two in a row. Still better odds than the regular crit in D&D. I just remembered. I should be running to power up my chicken knife. I should be running. You know what? I'll run on the way out. Because I'm gonna be going here, clearing the treasure, and then when I get to the because there's a boss fight before the save point, I'm gonna be running and running and running all the way back to the save point before the boss fight. Previous save point. And then I will run back for the boss fight. Final dungeon. Our final floor is the... You can tell because they got new music. Oh, hey, it's Greg! Greg's back! And there's a crystal dragon. These are the ones that you get the dragon spear from, but we already have one from one of the Jurai Avises. Thousand gil, 32 AP, no experience. yeah, the enemies in here no longer give experience points, but they give massive amounts of AP and kill. And AP, of course, is useful immediately for mastering your jobs. And Gil is useful if you want to run out and get the and buy more of the iron gear from Phantom Village or elixirs. Okay, so random encounter. I believe these ones only count. You know, in Final Fantasy IV, they only count. Well, they only do counter attacks. I believe they also counter magic with Meteor in this one. I can test that. Yeah, they will counter magic. Yeah, and they counter each hit is countered. Do they counter summons? Oh no, each of them only countered once. That's a relief. Oops, should have been a rise. Oh, whatever. Okay, so it's Greg. We're gonna talk to Greg. And we got the Genji here. Thank you. And now he recognizes us. I guess he sees different when he's in monster form. Hi, Greg. See you later. I believe you can get Roombos elsewhere as well. Yeah, you can definitely get them. Where do you get? I'll continue playing as I look it up on the menu. You can buy it in Phantom Village. I thought I bought everything from Phantom Village, but I guess I missed it. Oh no, here it is! There we go! That's a Gorshimera, which is a Gorgon that is also a Chimera that's part Gorgon. You can steal Ice Shield from them. I don't think you can steal any equipment from Necromancers, though. I think it's just, like, consumable status for strong items. And does Asuna work? I don't think so. Nope. Yeah, frost ice shields are rare steals, not common steals. So. And I believe we have seen all enemies. I believe that's all the random enemies in the interdimensional rift. Except for one. I And Glenna has Master Chemist. So what do we get next? Has anyone mastered Beastman? Has anyone mastered Geomancer yet? Yes, we have mastered Geomancer, we have mastered Bard, we have mastered Dancer. Has anyone mastered Blue Mage? I think I'll give that to Creel. Quartz is getting Dragoon next, I think. You know, I think we give Lena Monk so that. Yeah, I think Lena's gonna be the first one to master Monk. And where is it? Got the knuckles, there we go. There we go. Blood swords. Yeah, we have some of these, but we can get more. Another weak to water. Forgot that. These ones you can get dragon lance and elixirs. Oh, you can steal bone mail from them. So I was wrong, you can steal equipment from these things. How interesting that the Necromancers and King of the Behemoths are both weak against water. I did not know that. Gorshkimer is also weak against water. And you can steal Aegis shields from them. Where do you steal frost shields then? But I'm sure you can steal ice shields somewhere. Maybe it's in the bonus dungeon? In this treasure chest, that has Shinryu, the optional dragon super boss. The one that was mentioned in the book earlier. Oh, my shields are stolen from Numblades. And Numblades are... Where are they? There we go. Yeah, that's where you steal mine. That's where you steal life shield from. Yeah, here. Numblades and the Wind Shrine. Oh wait, no, is that the boss? I'm gonna look that up. I'll figure it out on the way. I'll grab it on the way out. I'm like 90% sure that that's a Shinryu thing. Oh yeah, Mind Flayer, so there are more enemies here. Yay, these ones, they cast Mind Blast, which is the blue magic that I learned from the Wind Shrine boss. If you miss it there and you don't get it from Quintania, you can get it here. I believe those are the only three places in the game where you can get it. Yeah, it does weak damage, but it also paralyzes or stuns or whatever. Okay, I looked it up. Previous chests to say. You can steal my goshes from them. Yeah, it's real good. That's one of the best defensive weapons in the game because it lets you carry incoming physical attacks. Forgot about those. Okay, yeah, so there's like a whole bunch of enemies here. I believe crystals absorb everything. I believe they absorb all elements and have a very high evasion rate, but they got like 1 HP or something like that. Yeah, see? Absorb holy. And I think these ones you can steal. Yeah. Like, yeah, I think you can get ethers and elixirs from them. Yeah, I believe Beastmaster is now Master. Yes. Okay, time for Blue Mage, I think? Yeah, Creole. Blue Mage really suits Creole thematically. Where's the chicken knife? Oh, there we go. Okay, let's see. What can we get from that? Yeah, so the water weakness means that Leviathan's pretty effective in here. Oh no, they got 3 hit points. And you can only get ethers from no elixirs. These ones you can get rising chains and windwing blades, and they drop ice shields. And that over there, that is the Shinryu chest. Yeah, these squids are real beefy. So many hit points. Still not as bad as the Final Fantasy 1 versions that can randomly one-shot you with irregular attacks. These ones, at least their stuns wear off in a couple turns. It's reflectable. Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I guess magic silence transparency is off in this one. Yeah. Yeah, deep lore 3.5 chip. Yeah. Yeah, and Samurai is mastered. We got Yainuki, which one-shots the entire, which has a chance to one-shot the entire enemy, has a chance to randomly one-shot each enemy, kind of like Odin, except it's not a spell, it's just a command, and it, doesn't cost any MP, and it takes, it takes a turn to charge, it has a charge time. Okay, now Thief. Power on the chicken knife so far. I'm gonna power it up. Gonna power it up to 127 eventually. But not on this stream. Oh no, Breathwing! Yeah, it's a percentile attack. So. But yeah, that can easily wipe your party if you get off too many. Oh no! Yes, as you can see, it can fail. No, I'm just chugging those elixirs. Well, good thing I can buy more. And I can steal them. I just don't want one from this dude. But... I can't remember when I've gone through so many elixirs in one battle. It is ridiculous. Are crystal dragons immune? And absorbs. Yeah, it absorbs lightning. That backfired. I think he's got like 10,000 hit points or something, so it should be almost defeated. Ooh, 17,500 hit points. Yeah, that's a lot. And I believe this is the final floor. And interesting, you see these roots over here? We will find out what those roots are about pretty soon. And then looks like a save point, but it's a weird non-standard save point. And we will find out, I will demonstrate what that does also soon, but not now. Hey, here's a trick. Because they only counter, you can just focus on the other enemy first. Yeah, Necromancer can't counter with Protect. Oof. Oh yeah, it's hard. Did they counter with zombie powder? Ooh, gotta run. I don't know, they just do that all with a regular ability. There we go. I just remember Time Agents have teleport. They can just warp out of battle with that. Yeah, and the Genji Shield is the most powerful shield. See what it stands. Yeah, it's 19 defense, 50% evasion, 1 magic defense, and immunity to minion paralysis. Okay, that's a better song. Is everything here immune to that? Yeah, I'll show off that other ability later. I'll take everything in here. These guys bomb them, they're cool. Yes, yes they are. Yeah, so that's what it does when it hits. Yeah, I think all the enemies in the final floors of the Dimensional Rift, I think all the enemies in the crystal area of the Dimensional Rift are immune too. Okay, so Creel has mastered Oracle. Bard. Beastmaster, Red Mage, Blue Mage, Summoner. Okay. Yell Master Thief, because Creel has the highest base agility. I'll adjust the skull before the boss fight. Oh, Chadley's here. Hey. Okay, just wrapping up. Gonna do a couple more boss fights and then raid out. Thank you. Oh no, it's this freak. Okay, I wasn't planning that, but it happened. I should change Ferris's skill because the Anuki doesn't work here. Okay, so what's Paris got? Rapid fire. Marks will get playbooks. Which I believe is mechanically better than rapid fire against three or more enemies. And two fights, I believe that should, this fight should give enough AP for Paris to match the Thief and then switch over to Summoner. Did I steal from the first one? No, I did not. I did not. Oh no no, not quite enough. Still need 5 more AP to match. Oh, hey, it's the movers. Those are the other enemies I was talking about earlier. And they managed to defeat them, I believe. Yep. Okay, movers have a gimmick. And their gimmick is that they, they got two formations. After a few turns, they switch from one formation to the other. And after a few more turns, they escape from battle and you don't get anything. And the switching of formations will reset the HP on them. Another weak against fire. So you have to deal a lot of damage really quickly. They got 10,000 hit points. And they're basically pinatas filled with AP and gil. And same in Final Fantasy 6 and 7. Actually, I believe in 6 they will use the meltdown spell, which hits pretty hard, so... Yeah, so farming these is the fastest way to master drones. And Paris is going to be a summoner for two reasons. One of them is in case we get more of the movers. And the other reason is... The other reason is for the next boss fight. Oops. time magic? And does Bart have a Dragon Lance or a Holy Lance? We'll check. Dragon Lance, okay. Yeah, so we can just crush this dude. Yeah, 9,000. Yeah, it's hard. Are these ones we use water? Or no, I don't think so. Oh, I keep forgetting Phoenix throws MP as well. Oh no, absorb lightning! Doesn't absorb meteor. And who has Master Thief? Yeah, so I guess that's supposed to be Tinkerbell, but it didn't want to. I guess their legal advisors told them to be careful or something. Thank you. Oh, there's his Kega Mask. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna refresh my drink and then do the boss fight. And I'm back. Okay. So what do we do for a setup? Okay. Blade Blitz is good. Blade Magic is good. Time Magic is good. Oh, no, 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 no. Yeah, I'm gonna have more Thieves. Yeah, I'm gonna get some backup thieves for the, Did I forget to pre-heal, or did they just do all that damage while I was healing? We'll be right back. Yeah, I forgot how hard these those things hit. And I believe that's enough to take out the bear. We have like 8,000 something hit points. No? Almost 9,000 hit points. Oh, they're not taking any damage from the... They're not taking any damage from the blade blitz. Yeah, you can steal high potions or reflect neck rings from the barriers. I should take out the last one. Really? Killing into Meteor even after the barrier? Maybe it takes a turn before the immunity fades? Yeah, it takes a turn because it's a script in action. What's his physical defense? Fifty magic defense. Why isn't hitting harder? That's about 15,000, I think. Oh, chicken knife. Part of you. That's like 25,000, I think. 35,000 maybe? I'm gonna defend for a turn to make sure. Is it time for Greg? Not yet. That should be enough. There we go! Greg's back! Yeah, this only happens if Necrophobe is under 10,000 hit points. I'm gonna cast quick. And we got the Genji armor. Yeah, I guess Necrophobe is immune to attacks once the script starts. Is he? Is he immune? Yes, he is. Thank you. Greg will return in Final Fantasy V. Or no. Greg will return in Final Fantasy 16. It was interesting. That green light thing, it doesn't look like a Final Fantasy V save point or a Final Fantasy IV save point, but it does look like a Final Fantasy VI save point. Except the ones in 6 are blue instead of green. But it's funny that it looks like a save point from a future game. Yeah, so this fight, you got Necrophobe here. You can steal Thief Clubs, I'm not going to. Barriers. And Gilgamesh, the final form. We got the Genji armor. Okay, so we're going to use a cottage, we're going to save, I'm going to show you the, Shinryu, and then final boss fight. Wait, can time... Does warp get you out of battle? Teleport get you out of battle? Yes, it does. Okay. Yeah, it does that in Final Fantasy IV as well. Not sure if it counts for Chicken Knife. Yeah, this is Shinryu, the legendary dragon, who guards the Ragnarok sword. Yeah, Shinryu's level and magic are so ridiculously high that, yeah, Tidal Wave does, like, over 6,000 damage. You can survive that by equipping the entire party with Portal Rings, or power leveling an obscene amount. You don't get a white mage. Yeah. Can we go with Aegis Shield for status resistance? Okay. Okay, time for the final boss. Oh, there's one more floor. There we go. This is the floor from the cinematics earlier, where Dextef is sending all the demons out to go after you. And yep, more trees. Yep, and that's Xdeath's true form, a giant tree. Interesting Easter egg. You can actually run away after this cinematic, and it will reverse time. I think you can run away. I don't remember. Yeah, so you can run out here. You know, it doesn't reverse it. I guess the towns got restored when the Dawn Warriors pushed back the power of the Void. So I guess that's why the towns are still around when you exit out of here. Yeah, and there's Exdeath, a giant tree. With a bunch of roots out there. Oh yeah, here's the And why do I have platelets for a single target fight? Just stick around, just stay tuned, we'll find out soon enough. Yeah, forgot how hard that can hit. And time
from the beach.
And you run this back at 4 MP. And phase two! Next death was engulfed by the wall. Yeah, and I'm guessing all these things, this whole demon slurry, is the forms of a bunch of the demons that were sealed into the tree that formed into the X-Death hive mind. My guess is that, like, the power of the void corroded the bonds of that hive mind, so now they're sort of just, like, all, like, spilling out. And each of the four segments has a rare steel available from it. In some builds of this game, particularly the earlier releases, you can actually, because the phase transition is scripted as a reaction to hitting zero HP, if you Berserk X-Death, Berserk status prevents reactions, so you can use the Kiss of Blessings Pharmacist mix command, the Kiss of Blessings mix combo to Berserk X-Death, which disables reactions, which allows you to skip this phase of the boss fight and just beat the tree and then go directly to the end. I believe each of the four segments deals nastier attacks when it gets low on HP. I'm gonna do quick so I can get more chances to do it. Yeah, I believe they're all rare 4% students. And I will show them after the end. That is a warning before they use one of their ultimate attacks. I think that's a warning for all Muggets, which is the thing that just hit most of us for like over 2,000 damage. Took off about like 3/4 of her hit points. Again, hit the one in the top left for way more than the others, because that one is coded as a dragon. It's vulnerable to Hollow's Harp and Dragon Lance. Yeah, bards are used. Hollow's Harp hits really hard in the final boss fight, but only against one of the segments. I meant to steal, but I hit the wrong direction on the control pad. Thank you. There we go. I believe one of them was defeated. Yep, took out the dragon segment. Okay, bottom right is just a Kuma shirt. And that was another one taken out. Oh, we already stole from that one. Yeah, that was another one. Yeah, only one segment. We'll be right back. Is Krillin using a Judgment Staff or a Sage's Staff? Sage's Staff. Okay, good. And there we go! Okay, so after this, I think the next game I'll be streaming is... Let's see, what do we got? I think a little bit of Blossom Tales, and then after that it will be Final Fantasy V again, but a different remake for the 4-Job Fiesta. And here there's a little narration, and this explains what's going on here. Yeah, and that's expository narration. Our heroes do not have in-character knowledge of that. They're discovering that how it works now. They're figuring it out. They're giving it a shot. I guess the crystals gave him a hint. Like, I'm guessing they intuitively understand this the same way they intuitively understand the jobs they got from the crystals. Like, it's knowledge they absorbed. Yeah, so the tablet. Yeah, so these tablets were stored at the original locations of the crystals. And this is why the crystals entrusted us with saving the world, because. because we could. Because, you know, the crystals were broken, but we could still put them back together. And the void could be pushed back. It's a dragon. And the Wind Shrine Crystal. Or Island Shrine Crystal. It's in mid. And we're back with the dragon. Yeah, Waltz is back. Moogle Village is back. Double eggs! Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, and there we got the Mode 7 3D graphics. Does it show a different animation for every for every job? Yeah, we have to, because they're still healed. They're supposed to summon. Yeah, summon Sildra. I guess let us use steel, I think. And March used it's funny that Krill just healed the boss for animation. Yeah, it's funny. Yeah, usually just power level through the jobs on the movers, and then everybody's a freelancer for the final boss. Don't remember, do you have to click something to save the clear data? Thank you. Yeah, you gotta click. A new passage has opened between the waves. That is the bonus dungeon. Save clear data. Yes. Yeah, Shiggles is here. Okay, so yeah, so we're back here, outside of the first town, and yeah, so now the monster list includes X-Death and Neo X-Death. And the steals are not. Oh, interesting. Steals are not shown in the monster data. Okay, so I gotta check the wiki for that. Okay, so I'm gonna save. I'm gonna read out to chat. Yeah, so the right segment, you can steal Murakumo. Top left segment, you can steal Dragonlance. Lower right segment, you can steal Kuma Shuriken. Lower left segment, you can steal Ragnarok. And each of those have a 3.91% steal rate. And in the original game, that's mostly just an Easter egg, because you can't save after the final boss. But in the remake, you can save your clear game clear data, so you can farm a unlimited number of Ragnaroks, and unlimited number of Ragnaroks by stealing from the lower left segment of Neo X-Death. The other three weapons can be obtained elsewhere. Okay, that's it. That's all for tonight. I'm gonna raid out.